Here at Special Effect, we're always looking for new games that we can do with our eye gaze users. And we appreciate that some games are quite fast, there are a lot of camera movements, a lot of clicking, and it can just seem quite daunting. So what we'll do today is look at some puzzle games using a Toby and a MyGaze camera. And they might be slightly addictive, I'll warn you, but there's no special software, it's just the one that comes with your camera. So that's what we'll be looking at today. So all I have here is a Surface tablet, and it has the Toby mounting bracket for the camera, which is on the front. And I have calibrated myself. We won't be running through that today because you'll have your own settings and we'll just be getting straight into the games. So I've done my calibration. I'm now in Windows Control using the Gaze Interaction software that comes with the Toby. And this will create a pop-up window. I've positioned mine in the top of the screen. And this is where all my click selections are hiding. So all I've done is I have set my blink as my click. I personally find that easier. It's whatever personal preference you have. And I also, for Bejeweled, have zoom click on. I've just activated the double click to launch the game, and I've taken it out of full screen mode because if you have it in full screen, it won't register your eye gaze. And so we just need to take it into windowed mode and we can get started. So the aim of the game is to match three or more colors in a row, and this will cause them to explode. So it's just a case of clicking on two of the shapes to swap them, and then they will disappear and give you points. Using this zoom to click function, the first blink will magnify the area of the screen you're looking at, and the second blink will actually be your click. So with a game like Bejeweled, where there's lots of little targets, it's sometimes helpful to have that zoom option. So I now have a very PC in front of me with a MyGaze camera, and I'm using MyGaze iMouse Play, which is the software that comes with the camera. And I will be showing you today Peggle. And all I'm going to do for this is, once my calibration is done, I will check that my dwell settings are all in order for my click. And then you just need to make sure that Peggle is not in full screen mode, otherwise this will mean that the eye gaze won't be picked up and you won't be able to play properly. So just take it out of full screen, which is within the game menu option, and then we can start. The aim of Peggle is to fire a cannonball at a whole bunch of balls on your screen, and this will select them and give you points with every ball that you hit. So the nice thing about Peggle is it can be quite fast, but you can take it at your own pace, and you only have to do one click to launch your ball and that's it. So I've set this to dwell, and I've got my animation showing of the loading pie, and that's showing me my feedback for my dwell. So for me, I personally prefer to pause the eye gaze in between my shooting of the cannonball just to give my eyes a bit of a rest, but this is your own personal preference. So I'm just going to do one click, aim, and then my ball's fired, and that's all you need to do. So this is called Jar of Marbles. Again, it's a nice simple point and click game. I will be continuing with the MyGaze camera and my left click. And I've just made sure that I have turned it out of full screen mode. To do this, you go into More, and then there's a drop down menu called Resolution. And so you click in there, exit full screen, and that's all you need to do. So today I'm going to make it easy on myself and go into beginner difficulty. And I've got my left click activated. That's all done. And it is what it says on the tin, basically, we have a jar of marbles and we want to connect them via groups of three in different color codes. This will cause them to explode and clear your jar. So I am just doing dwell to click, and I'm just looking at the part of the jar I want to drop my marble, and then dwell, and that's all you need to do. Thank you for joining us for this video on iGaze Gaming. I hope it's been useful, and we look forward to seeing how you guys get on.